Folks, how y'all doing today? It is time for another DVD update. Got some more DVDs to show you. I hadn't done a DVD update in a while, because to tell you the truth, I hadn't had enough money to buy these damn DVDs. Only way I get DVDs now, go to a damn cheapo store and get them for $5. That's really the only way I get my DVDs now, because I can't afford $20 a pop anymore. But I'll show you some more DVDs I got. Most of these have been out for a while, or just now went down in price. But sold my soul to the devil buying this one. I don't know why the hell I bought it, but I did. Halloween 2, the theatrical edition by Rob Zombie. As you know, you saw my video, I guess it was last year, I was talking about the when I saw it in theaters, and I didn't really like it. I admit it had some good scenes, but overall, it was a mess, and it could have done a little more with it. Everyone was raving how the unrated director's cut was so much better. I rented that from Netflix, and I wasn't too pleased with that one either. But I couldn't find the unrated version, but I got the theatrical for $5, and I say that's a pretty good deal. You can't beat that, but the only reason I really bought it was to have the whole Halloween set, because you know when you got OCD, you got to get them all, kind of like Pokemon, you got to catch them all. But I just felt like part of me is missing when I don't have the last sequel with that one and all that. It drives me nuts. So I bought it for $5. Shouldn't have wasted my money on it, but I did. But my sister likes it, so maybe she'll watch it. But sold my soul to the devil buying that one. Hopefully, if there's ever Halloween 3, it'll be better. Anyway, on for the next one. The It's Alive remake. I thought this was the uncut version, but it's actually the R-rated version. But from what I read on the internet, the R-rated version is not much different from the uncut version. It's only like 20 seconds of gore missing in the R-rated version. But the cover looks pretty good. What the hell is that down there? Is that you, Mitty? Damn, Mitty, you scared the crap out of me. I thought that was a damn rat or something. But, the cover looks very good, but when you see the actual movie, it's not really that great. It starts out pretty good, I'll admit, but I don't know, it just kind of ends all of a sudden. The trailer is actually better than the movie, I tell you the truth. But $5, you can't beat that, so I got some enjoyment out of it. The Hills Run Red. This is a pretty crazy one. The killer looks like a demented baby face, and it kind of reminds me of Dark Ride a little bit, by the way the killer looks. He has kind of like that baby face. Except in this one, the killer looks a lot uglier than that movie Dark Ride with that kid that played in The Big Green. I can't remember his name. He's not big anymore. He used to be pretty big in that movie. But he was in the Dark Ride, and there was a killer that looked like a baby face in it. How you doing, matey? But this is a pretty crazy one. It's very bloody, very gory, and very wild. Nice twist near the ending, too. Did you like that one, Mitty? You did? All right. Time for another killer baby movie, Grace. I have to say, this is a pretty weird one. I wasn't expecting much when I got it for $5, and I said, oh, it's probably not going to be that great. But it turned out I liked it. I liked it a lot better than It's Alive, I'll tell you that. But a nice little ending. The baby damn bites the mother's, I won't say. But it's pretty disturbing. Got a lot of flies in it and all that. It's a pretty strange movie. So if you like them killer baby flicks, you want to check out that one. Another remake, Sorority Row. This one, I like some parts and some parts I didn't like. Personally, I like the original better, House on Sorority Row. I want to buy that one day. If I can find it anywhere, I think I'm going to have to order it off the internet, because ain't nobody carried it in stores. No Best Buy, no Fry's, no nobody. Probably going to have to order that one from Amazon one day. But this one's all right. It has some pretty good parts and some parts I didn't like. It kind of reminds me of I Know What You Did Last Summer, sort of. But it's a pretty good slasher if you like them. Here's another slasher, the Stepfather remake, unrated director's cut. I don't even know why they called it the unrated director's cut. I can't tell no damn difference in this version compared to the theatrical version. I couldn't tell a difference at all. They didn't put that buzzsaw scene in there, that nice buzzsaw scene we saw in that TV commercial where they're all down on the floor and the damn buzzsaw's coming down all in their face. I wasn't in the movie. I'm like, damn, I wanted to see that. It's not in this version either, so that's false advertisement there, folks. I don't like being lied to. Another remake. Remember I said that video I did a while back? I'm like,
it's me, Isaac. You might remember me from Children of the Corn.
Said I wasn't going to buy this movie till it was $5 or less. Well, I didn't buy it till it was $5. Only reason I bought it was to have the whole damn Children of the Corn collection. But personally, I was not a big fan of this one. The original is much better. I don't even know why the hell they remade it. I heard they're remaking it again and putting it in theaters, so I don't know why the hell they're doing that. And this is a very good one. I got this one also for $5. Train with Thor Birch. This is a remake of Terror Train, which is right there, right next to me, with Jamie Lee Curtis. But this is a lot different than the original. I mean, the story don't even seem the same at all to me. It's kind of like you take Hostel and you put them on a train and just a lot of killing and murdering. I tell you, it is pretty damn crazy. One of the best $5 DVDs I bought in a while, I'll tell you that. But I enjoyed it. Thor Birch did a good job, and it's pretty damn crazy and pretty violent. I'm like, good Lord. But if you like Hostel, you want to check out this one, because it's like you take Hostel and stick them on a train, and that's where you get trained. But that's a wild one. And for those wondering, the old It's Alive, I pulled those out too and show you in this video. There's the old It's Alive. Personally, my favorite one is probably It's Alive 3, Island of the Alive. But I'll be doing a hard time on killer baby movies, so stay tuned for that. I'll be doing that one pretty soon. Well, that's all I got to say. I'll see y'all later. Have a gory good day. Bye-bye.